Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to start with the topic cleaning organization. Myself Paramveer Singh, associate professor with Chitkara School of Hospitality. So let's start cleaning organization. In today's video we will study about the following processes, that is principles of cleaning and frequency of cleaning. So let's begin. Before we start principles of cleaning and frequency of cleaning, let's discuss what is cleaning. In simple words, cleaning is the process of removing unwanted substances such as dirt, infectious agents and other impurities from an object or environment. So cleaning is the process in which we can make things look beautiful and we can make them hygienically clean. So what is cleaning? Cleaning is the process of removing dust or dirt or any other hazardous impurities from the surface. Cleaning occurs in many different contexts and use many different methods. The contexts and the methods which are used in cleaning are, under contexts we have commercial cleaning in healthcare settings, environmental remediation, that is the removal of pollution or containments from the natural environment. Spring cleaning, we are going to discuss that in the later part of the video. Hygiene, that is your personal grooming. And under methods, we have various methods of cleaning like washing, dry cleaning, green cleaning, that is using environmental friendly methods and products. Acoustic cleaning, that is the use of sound waves which helps the dirt to leave the surface and fall on the ground with the help of gravity, and later on we can clean them with various different methods. Steam cleaning, that is used in both domestic as well as industrial purposes. So let's begin. Principles of cleaning. There are basic rules to follow in any kind of cleaning activity, whatever the nature of the surface or the soil is. There are certain rules, there are certain principles which needs to be followed while doing the cleaning. All loose dirt and litter should be removed before dealing with any stubborn stains. So in case you have anything stuck to the ground or on the floor, you should remove the rest of the dirt. You can remove rest of the dirt easily, and then later on you can deal with that particular stain which is, or particular thing which is stuck to the surface. Loose dust and litter should be removed without harming the surface being cleaned or the surrounding surfaces. That's what. Loose dirt particles can be cleaned with mopping or with the help of vacuuming, and later on you can deal with the thing which is stuck to the ground. The surface should be restored to its original state after the cleaning process. This is also a very important point. After you do the cleaning, the surface should look actual to the original surface, what it was earlier. Abrasives should be used as a last resort as they can damage the surface. For abrasives, I'll give you an example of a steel wool. That is a hard abrasive, or sand, because they damage the surface if you use them harshly. Use an agent that is least offensive in smell if alternatives are available. Use the chemicals which don't have a foul smell or which don't have a high smell so that the guests don't get irritated with the smell. Use methods that are least convenient to guests, that are least familiar to the guest. When cleaning the area, start with the cleaner surfaces and the articles, and then go on to clean more heavily soiled ones so as to prevent the spread of soil from dirty to cleaner surfaces. Loose dirt, once the items which are less dirty, you can clean them easily, and then you can move on to the surface which is heavily soiled. So that heavily soil can be cleaned easily, and in case you clean the loose dust later on, then there are chances that it might fly and again settle down on some other surface. The cleaning process should be efficient using a minimum of equipments, cleaning agents, labor and time. Cleaning should be done as soon as possible, and the items on which the cleaning is performed, they should be spick and span after the cleaning is done. They should be restored to their original cleaning or original shape and size. The simplest method should be tried first, using the mildest cleaning agents. The cleaning methods least harmful for the surface should be used. We should not use harsh chemicals at the beginning itself. While wet cleaning or polishing the floor, the cleaner should walk backwards while cleaning in front of him. We should always walk backwards while cleaning so that you should not step on the surface which you have already cleaned. So you should move backwards to the door, facing inside the door, and you should clean in front of yourself so that you should not step on the area which you have cleaned. Suction cleaning should be preferred over sweeping wherever possible. Suction cleaning is basically done with the help of vacuums. So whenever that thing is possible, prefer suction cleaning. Sweeping should be done before dusting. You should always do sweeping first and then you do the dusting part, because once you do the dusting first and then you sweep the floor, there are chances that the dust might fly again from the sweeping and it settles down on the area which you have already cleaned. Noise levels while cleaning should be kept as low as possible. The reason being why the noise levels need to be kept low, because the guests in the other rooms, they might get disturbed with the noise you produce while doing the cleaning job. Stains should be removed as soon as they occur. As soon as you get a stain, you try to remove it then and there itself. In that way, you will put less efforts to clean it. Once it gets settled down, then it will be very hard to remove that. The cleaner should take all safety precautions while cleaning. For example, cleaning agents and equipment should be stacked neatly at one side of the trolley. Be sure that the process of cleaning areas do not become accident prone. So proper warning signs need to be put on the floors in case you are doing a wet mop. So you should keep a sign which states wet mop in process or the floor is wet, so that the passerbys can easily note it down and they should avoid moving in that area. The cleaner should start cleaning from the farthest end of an area, working towards the exit. Let's suppose a GRA is cleaning a room. So the GRA has to start from the farthest end from the entrance of the room so that the area can be cleaned backwards, and at the time of finishing the cleaning, the person who is cleaning, the GRA, should be at the entrance of the room. After the cleaning process is over, all equipment should be washed or wiped as applicable, dried and stored properly. Cleaning agents should be replenished and stored for the next use. Next is frequency of cleaning. Cleaning tasks may be divided according to the frequency of their scheduling, which depends upon the following factors. First is the level of soiling, the type of surface, the amount of traffic, the type of hotel, and the cleaning standards. So all these five factors are responsible for carrying out the cleaning at various intervals, you can say. The level of soiling is the amount of dirt or dust you are getting in. The type of surface, whether it's a wooden surface or a ceramic tile surface or a marble floor. The amount of traffic will depend upon the number of footfall, the number of people moving in that area, the type of hotel, let it be a business hotel or a normal tourist hotel or something, cleaning standards, the type of cleaning methods you use, that also depends upon the frequency of cleaning. The greater the amount of soiling, the greater will be the frequency of cleaning carried out. The more frequently you are getting the area soiled, the more frequently you need to get it clean. Cleaning tasks are carried out as per one of the following frequency, that is daily tasks, that is daily cleaning, weekly cleaning or weekly tasks, and periodic tasks, or that depends upon the schedules which is made by the head of the department. So let's begin with daily tasks. These are routine operations carried out on a day-to-day basis by the staff of the housekeeping department. Your daily tasks includes cleaning of floors, cleaning of guest room areas, and so on. These include the regular servicing of guest rooms, cleaning of bathrooms and toilets, suction cleaning of floors and floor coverings, and so on. Weekly tasks include, these are the term implies are routine tasks carried out on weekly basis. They may include the polishing of metal surfaces, dusting on hard to reach areas, and so on. Hard to reach areas might be like your top of the paintings in the room, or your AC ducts, AC filters. And under weekly tasks, we can have a schedule that on Monday we will clean all the switchboards, on Tuesday we'll clean all the AC filters, on Wednesday we'll clean all the under the bed areas, on Thursday we'll clean all the back house areas, or like your fire exit, staircase, and so on. So these are the weekly tasks which are scheduled by the head of the department, and then they are given to the supervisors to get the particular areas and surfaces clean on weekly basis. Periodic tasks, these are carried out on a monthly, quarterly, or half yearly or annual basis. Like spring cleaning, it is a special type of periodic cleaning. Some of the usual periodic tasks in hotel include the shampooing of carpets, washing of walls, cleaning of chandeliers, and stripping and polishing of floors. These are the tasks which are carried out on various interval levels, like monthly or quarterly or half yearly or on annual basis. That depends upon the hotel, and that depends upon property to property, and that also depends upon the amount of guests you are getting in. The higher the standards required, the greater is the task carried out daily, and greater the amount of soiling, the greater will be the frequency which is carried out. If you require higher standards, then the tasks are need to be carried out on daily basis, and if the amount of soiling is more, then the frequency of the cleaning needs to be increased to get the set standards. That's all for today, and in the next video we will study about orthodox or conventional or traditional cleaning, block cleaning, team cleaning, deep cleaning, and special projects. Last but not the least is spring cleaning in detail. Till then, thank you, have a nice day. Be safe. Thank you very much.